Hi students, now I am going to explain about addition of fractions, chapter number 6, fractions. In that we are going to do addition of fractions, exercise number 6.3. Here see one question, question number 7 is different type. Here these are maybe new for you, I think. Mixed fractions. Till now, you have done with only normal fractions, but here different fractions are in different. That is, they are in mixed fractions. So 1 3 by 4, 2 5 by 8 plus 3. Now how to add? Yes, see, before adding, see the fractions. They are in normal fractions or not? Here mixed fractions. We should not do additions in mixed fractions. So what to do? The mixed fractions, whatever the given mixed fractions, convert into normal fractions. So here see how to convert into normal fractions. See, multiply these two, denominator and this whole number, this denominator in the fraction and whole number, these two multiply. 4 1 4, for that result add this one. Then you will get to 4 1 4 plus 3 7 by 4. See, I have done here, multiply these two, 4 1 plus 3, the total you write in a numerator and denominator repeat. Now what you get here? 4 1 4 plus 3 7, denominator repeats 4 7 by 4. Once again multiply these two, divisor and whole number, denominator and whole number, multiply. For that add this one, the total write in a numerator and denominator, this 4 as it is repeats plus. Now here also one more mixed fraction is there, same way, 8 2 16 plus 5, 16 plus 5, 21. That total write in numerator. Total write in a numerator. See what I did? 8 2 jar, multiply these two, whole number and remind, whole number and denominator. Denominator and whole number multiply. 8 2 jar, 16, and add 5. 16 plus 5, how much? 21. By this denominator repeats as it is. The denominator repeats as it is. Plus next number. What is the next number? 3. In previous class I told, if only number is given as 3, in case you also can write denominator as 1. For any number denominator, there will be a denominator is 1. So if you want here denominator, you can write as 1. Why? Here we are doing fractions now. So this number also we can convert as write as a fraction. We can write by 1. Nothing is there means there is a denominator for any number, that is 1 only. Denominator for any number is 1. Why? Here we are adding additions of fractions. So this also I am making in the form of fraction. Now yes, you got new fractions. You converted these mixed fractions to normal fractions. These normal fractions now in the form of improper fractions. Any time mixed fraction after converting normal fractions, they are improper fractions. So that means numerator will be bigger than the denominator. See, improper fractions you will get. Mixed fraction converting, you will get improper fractions. And this denominator, this number again, 3, you write as 3 by 1. Why I wrote 3 by 1? Make as fraction. Make as that also, that number also write as a fraction. Now we are adding fractions now. So to make this number also, make as fraction by writing denominator as 1. No denominator means by 1. Okay, now add. You know how to add. This, see, these are unlike fractions. When you are doing unlike fractions, how to add unlike fractions? Convert unlike fractions into like fractions. In previous I told, like if the given fractions are like fractions, what to do? Directly denominator repeats and numerators add. But here unlike fractions, in case of unlike fractions, what you have to do? Make the fractions as like fractions. Okay, to make into like fractions, what to do? Now take denominators and find LCM. First take denominators 4, 8, 1. Find LCM. Now LCM 4, 1, ja, 4, 4 table possible. If any number possible in any table is possible in all numbers, you can take. But here no table is possible one table only possible. But here no need to do it one. Other than one, any other table you do it. 4 table. So 4 table possible in 2. Even 2 numbers possible, you can take it as factor. Yes, see, dividing factor is, if any 2 numbers possible also you can take it. Out of all possible, that number you can take it. If not possible, all numbers, if minimum 2 numbers possible also, you can take the table to divide. Now yes, in 4 and 8, 4 table possible. So 4 1 jar 4, 4 2 jar 8. If it is not possible in any number, take down as it is. In 1 not possible, 4 is not possible in 1. 4 divide, not divides 1 now. So then 4 not possible means as it is, that number write as it is. Take down. Whatever number is there, take down just. Now see, is there any table possible in 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1? Is there any common factor for all these 1, 2, 1? Any number, any table is possible in all? So only one table. If you write it with, if you divide with one table, again same numbers only will come now. No need to do with one table. No time waste. Don't do. So enough, leave it. Is there any table possible in all numbers? No. Minimum 2 numbers possible, one table only. Here 1, 1, 2 numbers. No need to do. So if minimum 2 numbers possible, you can take it. Otherwise, time waste, don't do. So not even any 2 numbers are not possible by any table. So leave it. So then multiply all outside numbers. 4 into 1 into 2 into 1. Multiply all outside numbers. 4 into 1 into 2 into 1. That is only LCM. 4 1 jar 4, 4 2 jar 8, 8 1 jar 8. Now after multiplying all these, you get LCM as 8. Once again, 4 1 jar 4, 4 1 jar 4, 4 2 jar 8, 8 1 jar 8. So such a way multiply, you will get LCM. What is LCM? LCM is 8. Now write take all these fractions individually, 7 by 4, 24, 21 by 8 and 3 by 1. Take separately all these fractions and write as equal fractions. Then when you are writing equal fractions, denominator must be, for all equal fractions, denominator must be equal to LCM. So here, what is the LCM? 8 now. Now write these given fractions. Given fractions convert as convert into equal fractions, such that LCM, the denominator in all fractions must be equal to LCM. Now see, 7 by 4, I want denominator as equal to LCM. So 7 by 4, then to get 8, what you have to multiply to 4? 2 table. In numerator also multiply with 2 table. So then you will get 14 by 8. Why you are multiplying 2 table in both numerator and denominator? If here condition is, I want 8 as denominator. 8 as denominator. 8 as LCM. So to get that, we have to multiply 4 with 2. Then 7 also with 2. Why I am multiplying 2 table with both numerator and denominator? To get equal fraction. Now we got equal fraction. Now we have come to next fraction. What is the next fraction? 21 by 8. 21 by 8. Here I want denominator as LCM. Denominator must be equal to LCM. That is 8. So what you will get? What number you multiply to 8 to get to 8? So one table only. One table. So one already 8 is there in the fraction. I want get denominator as LCM. 8. I want 8. Already 8 is there. So no need to multiply with any other table except 1. So, and 1 is, if you multiply with 1, same only will come, no? So one table. So here also numerator, when I multiply down denominator with 1, numerator also multiply with 1. Why we are multiplying numerator and denominator with the same numbers? To get equal fractions. Now we got equal fraction for 21 by 8. Equal fraction is 21 by 8 only. Next come to next number. Next fraction, 3 by 1. Only 3 is given. We have written as 3 by 1. We can write any number as 3 by 1. So okay. no denominator, we can write as denominator as 1. No, I said now here 3 by 1. Now 3 by 1, I want denominator condition. I want denominator must be equal to LCM. So what is LCM? 8. I want make denominator as LCM. How to convert into 8? Then how we get 8? By multiplying with this given fraction, multiply denominator, multiply with 8, you will get denominator as 8. Always denominator must be equal to LCM. So LCM, what we got LCM in up, that should be equal to 8. So that is 8. That number 1 into 8, you will get 8. So you are multiplying with 8, numerator also multiply with 8. Why we are multiplying numerator and denominator with the same table? To get a equal fraction. So then you got to equal fraction is 24/8. Now take another fraction. What is the next fraction here? Next fraction is 3/1. 3/1 is over, no? Yes, all over. 3/1 is over. Next, take all the fractions. Add given fractions. Add here like fractions. See, first fraction like fraction equal fraction. First fraction equal fraction is 14/8. Second fraction equal fraction is 21/8. Third fraction equal fraction is 24/8. Now see the new fractions. In the place of these fractions, equal fractions we have written. So now see the new fractions, how they are looking. They are looking as like fractions. Yes, all denominators same, no? Like fractions. Yes, easy to do now. Now repeat the denominator as it is. Okay, denominator repeats here in answer. Only numerator should be add. When you are adding like fractions, what to do? Repeat the denominator in answer. Denominator should be repeat and numerators should be add. So I am adding numerators 14 plus 21 plus 24. Then I got 59. Denominator repeats as it is 59/8. It is improper fraction. Any time answer should not be in a improper fraction. What to do? Divide. If you divide, what will happen here? Divide. See, 59 divided with 8. 59 divided with 8. So 8 7 are 56. What is the remainder? 3. So what is the answer now? 3/7, 3/8. Quotient and remainder by divisor. That is the final answer. Quotient and remainder by 7/3/8. This is the final answer. Such a way we can convert mixed fractions and we can solve remaining. Only here new thing is converting is mixed fraction is new for you. Remaining all same as previous problems. But here only converting mixed fraction as normal fractions. That's all for now. Thank you.